topic, the more confusions there are. I am still not really sure. Fujairah came out with quite some time ago, open scrubbers will not be allowed. Other port authorities haven't said anything yet. FTA is saying open scrubbers will be allowed, but of course port authorities have their own right to decide within their territory. I did an exercise recently. I tried to find out the port territories. Just looking at just the Emirates, which one are they? So if I'm in UAE waters, which one are the port territories? I couldn't find them. If I, as a lawyer, can't find them, how is a master on board a ship supposed to figure out where he actually is right now? So there were quite a lot of issues. And I must say, I only found the port territories from Fujairah, and that was written so complicated that I did not understand a word. So again, you show me a sea chart, I could not have pointed it out to you. I just know it's a big territory, but there's still a lot of confusion.
The UAE has now, as you all know, become the first Arab nation to win Category B membership of the International Maritime Organization, IMO Council. The win was the result of an election that included nominees from 11 leading countries in the international marine trade sector, such as Germany, Sweden, Netherlands, Brazil, Argentina, France, and Australia. These achievements do not stop here, as we are pushing to continue the country's competitive role competitiveness within the global trade and international economy.
Another concern that I've heard is scrubbers are not designed at the moment to operate 24/7. They are designed for short-term operation. And the scrubbers that I know of exist in tankers under inert gas systems, not on the main engine. So I've heard operators, various owners screaming that the main engines are going to be facing a lot of issues because the pressure blowback is going to be there.
The regulation is very clear in black and white. So I think there was an MEPC 74 which cleared the remaining cobwebs in that regulation. So the regulation perspective is clear. However, it's the first time that there is a regulation for the best prepared ship manager in the world or ship owner. There is still a mist. He is not sure of whether there would be sufficient fuel availability in each port. He is not sure whether he will have a fuel which is blended or is it originally from the refinery. He doesn't know how the compatibility of the fuels will be, and I think it's something which he will have to face over the first few months of 2020 to be able to really decide the best way out.